last! My victory is at hand! Har, har, har! Behold, the legendary 13th monkey of Montevideo! Har, whose sacrifice will eternally bind the oceans themselves to my infernal will! Har, har! Impressed yet?
Half as much as I'll be when Guybrush guts your diseased carcass with his voodoo cutlass, you doddering sack of scum.
I wouldn't hold your breath waiting for any last-minute heroics, dear. The last I saw of your mighty pirate husband, he was being torn apart by a school of my ravenous piranha poodles.
All right, LeChuck, put down the monkey and back away from my wife.
Guybrush!
Arr, threefold! You've led me a merry chase, but soon the dread mysteries of these ancient simians will be mine, and the seas will run red with the blood of my enemies. Har, har, har!
Fight like a...
No time to waste, Guybrush. Finish enchanting that sword before LeChuck completes his spell.
I'm on it. One LeChuck-defeating cursed cutlass of Kafflu coming up.
Now, where did I leave those handy voodoo instructions?
They're pinned to your mast!
Oh, yeah.
Come to Guybrush, you spooky voodoo recipe, you.
Well, I had to sail 6 of the 7 major seas to find the ingredients, but I finally finished the cutlass. Almost. Now all I need to do is find some fizzy root beer to spray on it, and LeChuck's as good as toast.
Dicky disease toast.
Ah, the legendary monkey casket of Kauai. I'll never forget the horrible hula of Hades I had to do to get this thing.
Is this thing sloshing?
4 words you don't want to hear when you pick up a coffin.
Arr, arr,
arr. I wonder how you open this thing.
Aha! A seltzer bottle full of root beer.
I haven't seen one of these since before I had a beard.
Bet this stuff will work wonders on my cutlass.
Arr, arr, arr.
Whoa, this city.
Eat your frosty carbonated maker, LeChuck.
Arr! Come and get me, a dirty and oily dipper! Arr!
Stop showboating and spray the sword, Guybrush!
I'm not showboating, I'm...
Arr!
Whoa!
Oops. And now we're going to die. Again. Wonderful.
Okay, no problem. I just need to find a fresh supply of impossible-to-find voodoo root beer.
I sure hope there's some on Elaine's ship, because mine is dry as a bone. And not one of those wet bones. I'm talking a dry, dry bone.
Elaine, my beautiful butter...
What?
I said, Elaine, my beautiful butter...
My beautiful butter?
I was going to say buttercup, but you keep cutting me off.
Oh, Guybrush. Now stop the chuckle, we're all dead.
I don't know what to do.
Neither do I think...
What's going on here?
LeChuck hijacked my ship and sailed to the Rock of Gelato to finish his terrifying voodoo ritual. It's a good thing we've got the Cutlass of Kafflu on our side, or we'd be done for.
Elaine, you've got inordinately strong thighs. See if you can swing me that rope.
It's not long enough, but I've got a better idea.
How'd you do that?
He had spent several years at the side of Guybrush Threepwood, mighty pirate, without picking up a few tricks, darling.
My ship! My booty! My collection of autographed sextants!
We'll buy you some more sextants later. Just stop LeChuck.
Ah, Threepwood. So good of you to join us. Saves me the trouble of having to sink your ship.
Let's see if we can cut back some of those unruly roots. There, much neater. Busy locale grog. I bet I can make a fortune selling this to, well, no one. Now that's some fizzy root grog. I bet it still tastes like monkey stuff. Okay, you barrel of disgusting locale goo, make yourself useful. Booyah! Look out, LeChuck! Here comes Guybrush Threepwood's glowing sword of hot monkey vengeance!
LeChuck! Do you mind? I'd be in the middle of an unholy ceremony here.
Unholy this!
Unholy this?
Yeah, I know, but he didn't give me much to work with. Hey!
Arr, arr. You can't defeat me that easily, Sheepwood. Wait, what's happening?
Is that how the cutlass is supposed to work?
I don't know, it's so bright. What the heck?
Woof.
I'm human.
That's debatable.
Guybrush, quick! Finish him off!
What? Oh, right! This is for the monkeys, LeChuck!
What are you doing? Finish him!
It's not me, it's my hand! It won't...
Uh-oh.
Elaine!
Guybrush?
Ahoy there, me hearty!
What?
Don't worry! We'll have you up and sucking back a grog in... No! My note! My beautiful pirate note! I'll get you for this, you craven bilge rat!
Sorry, I don't know what got into me.
Oh, this can't be good.
You know, you really should have that looked at, kid.
Huh?
The name's Nipperkin. Davy Nipperkin, senior reporter, Keel Hauler Gazette. Welcome to Flotsam Island. Mind if I ask you a few questions?
Actually,
great! What's your name, where'd you come from, and how'd you get here?
I'm Guybrush Threepwood, mighty pirate, and...
Pirate, eh? Well, I believe it when I see it, kid. Still, it'd be nice to have a real genuine pirate buckling his swash around Flotsam Island again. Why, I haven't had an honest-to-goodness pirate story to write about in over 6 months.
You're right.
Yes, sorry, Bob. Nothing like the promise of a good pirate story to get the old journalistic juices flowing again, says I. Say, just listen to me prattling on while you stand there all wet and confused and whatnot. So, what's your story, Creepwood?
This island looks, lovely, but where can I find a ship? I really need to get back to the Rock of Gelato and find my wife.
Well, there's only one ship here on Flotsam Island, but it won't do you any good.
Why not?
It's the winds, Threepwand, the winds! Here on Flotsam Island, the winds are always blowing inward 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. It's a freak of nature, a fluke, a curse. Whatever you want to call it, the result is the same. Once you've landed on Flotsam Island, you're trapped!
Are you seriously telling me there's no way off this island?
Well, not by ship, anyway. The only person who I think might know a way off the island is Deep Gut.
Deep Gut? What's a Deep Gut?
Deep Gut's my secret source for off-island news stories. And it's a good thing, too. Without the Gut's uncanny inter-island scoops, the Keelhauler Gazette would never be able to compete with those snooty prima donnas over at the Flotsam Times.
Off-island news? Hey, then he might know something about Elaine. Where can I find this Deep Gut?
Hold on a second, pirate boy. Davy J. Nipperkin doesn't go handing over his secret sources to every Tom, Dick, and Guybrush that washes ashore.
But I can pay you with treasure from my ship, which is probably at the bottom of the ocean by now.
Look, kid, you seem like a nice enough pirate, so I'll make you a deal.
A deal?
Yeah. Off-island news is nice and all, but the fair citizens of Flotsam are getting tired of stories about faraway lands they'll never see again. Not to mention that I hate being beholden to this Deep Gut person.
So?
So I need some nice, meaty, local pirate news.
I love making pirate news.
That's the spirit, kid! You can translate that moxie into news-making pirate mayhem, and I'll hand you Deep Gut on a silver platter!
Yeah, this'll be a snap. A snap. A snap. Ow! Hi.
Ah, who are you?
I'm Guybrush Threepwood, Mighty Pirate. And you are?
Joaquin Jacinto de Mera Alfonso de Oro, treasure hunter extraordinaire.
What kind of treasure do you hunt? Gold doubloons? Silver triploons?
Anyone can find gold or silver. I look for the rarest of pirate treasures.
I'm almost certain I'm going to regret asking this, but what is the rarest of all pirate treasures?
Porcelain power pirates.
Can I call you Doro the Explorer?
No.
What's that big pink pile of dolls?
Action figurines.
Okay, what's that big pink pile of action figurines over there all about?
Those are my extra pink pajama pierres, the lamest and least valuable of the porcelain power pirates. I loathe pink pajama pierres with the white-hot intensity of a million exploding cannonballs.
Did the wind shipwreck you on Flotsam Island too?
Yes, but I came here voluntarily in search of the elusive Dark Ninja Dave porcelain power pirate action figure.
What were you doing down there?
Nothing.
It looked like you were playing with dolls.
They're not dolls. They're polyarticulated porcelain power pirates.
What in the name of Davy Jones's closet organizer are porcelain power pirates?
They're the rarest and coolest action figures ever. I've been tracking them with the Porcelain Power Pirate treasure maps hidden in special boxes of Porcelain Power Pirate pear-flavored breakfast cereal. I've spent years tracking them down, and I've almost got the full set.
How many PP Pirates do you have left?
The only Power Pirate I have not found is the ultra-rare, impossible-to-find Dark Ninja Dave with killer karate katana. I thought I might find it here on Flotsam Island, but I got scammed.
Scammed?
Jace, some guy in a plaid jacket with waving arms sold me a Ninja Dave map, but he just keeps sending me in circles.
What makes Dark Ninja Dave so rare?
Because a bunch of pirate parents had him banned on account of his pointy killer karate katana accessory. They said it was a choking hazard. Wimps.
Mind if I take a look at that map?
Take it. It's useless.
I'll let you know if I find anything. You're sure this Dark Ninja Dave is a valuable treasure, right?
It's the stuff that dreams are made of. Porcelain dreams.
Look! It's a Ninja Dave figure with throwing star action!
Where?
Okay, Guybrush. It's only a little porcelain. Just close your eyes and go to your happy place. Ew.
I didn't see anything.
Sorry, must have been a leaf. Smilin' Stan's Young Miss Mini Bombs. All the punch of larger mini bombs packed into a smaller package for petite pirate hands. You know, I better just take all of them. Holy screaming starfish! I think I've just found my ride off this stinking island.
Not so fast, my well-coiffed friend.
Who?
Reginald Van Winslow, captain of the Screaming Narwhal. And you are?
Guybrush Threepwood, mighty pirate.
Oh, really? What can I do for you, Mr. Mighty Pirate?
Nice ship. Were you drunk when you built it?
Good one, boyo. But I didn't build the Screaming Narwhal. It was assembled by a committee of concerned Flotsam citizens.
Were they drunk?
No, but they had to use whatever floated ashore. Hence, the aforementioned constructed by Sot's Look.
Well, if you didn't build the Narwhal, why are you the captain?
By tradition, whoever knocks the captain of the Screaming Narwhal off the deck gets to be the captain until he's knocked off by the next guy.
So all I have to do is knock him off, huh? How'd you end up on Flotsam?
Same as everyone else here, lad. The winds! I was chasing some brigand that had stolen my hard-earned booty when all of a sudden Flotsam's capricious winds picked up my ship, shredded it to bits, and plunked me down here on her bounteous shores.
Heave to and strike your colors. I've come to seize your ship.
You have? Jolly good. No one's been man enough to take the Screaming Narwhal for over 2 years.
He's got a really good attitude for someone who's about to lose his ship. Why are you so happy about me seizing your ship?
I love a good challenge. Girds the mind and sharpens the loins, don't you know?
Huh? Be seeing ya.
I look forward to it.
Prepare to be boarded, Ben Winslow.
Bacon grease, boyo. Slickest stuff in the seven seas.
Oh, crud. This jacket was an anniversary present. And now it's all covered with bacon grease. Man, is Elaine gonna be PO'd. Oh, dang. Hot, hot, hot! Ow! And now the dock is smoldering. Perfect! Hey, there's something in this sock. Club 41, probationary member number 37, Reginald Van Winslow. This should come in handy.
The weather never ever does a thing for me.
Okay, now what? It's a good thing Winslow's undies have so much crotchal support. No, don't, please.
You'll have to be a lot sneakier than that if you want to knock me off, lad.
Oh, I wouldn't say that.
What? Clever boy. Well played, Master Threepwood. Or should I say, Captain Threepwood.
Captain?
Aye, now that you've bounced me off the screaming narwhal, you're officially its captain! Until someone else comes along and knocks you off!
Sweet!
Aye, bloody well sweet it is! Now if you'll excuse me, I have some massive internal hemorrhaging to attend to. Congratulations!
I just got a tip there's some kind of wanton piracy going on around here!
Not just any wanton piracy, a genuine ship seizure committed by none other than Captain Guybrush Threepwood, mighty pirate. Guybrush is one word.
Wonderful! I could probably get a week's worth of stories out of this. Well, keep up the swashbuckling, Threepwood, and I'll be forking over the secrets of Deep Cut in no time. Alphabet sail!
Oh, yes, my membership card. Here you go.
Very good, Captain Van Winslow. Here's your blindfold.
Blindfold?
Come now, sir. You know the rules. All probationary Club 41 members must wear blindfolds inside the club.
Right. How silly of me.
Very good, sir. Find the step.
I've heard you make a mean grogatini.
Look out!
I'm so sorry. Sorry. Ow!
Get him!
Ow!
Snoop! Out for his hand!
You took the hand off me, you cracker croaker!
What a fight! That was spectacular, Driftwood! Best pirate brouhaha I've seen in months!
I don't know what got into me. It was like my hand was possessed or something.
Possessed, you say? Sounds like there may be a follow-up story there. Keep feeding me these boffo pirate stories, Threepwood. I'll be handing over the secrets of Deep Cut before you know it.
What the? You put one of those miniature swords with an olive in my grogatini. I hate those things. Hey, what do you know? That little teeny sword fits right into Pierre's little teeny hand. Still doesn't look very fearsome, though.
Beware, Pink Pajama Pierre. You foiled me plans for the last time. Prepare to meet your maker in the ebon depths of the inky sea.
Sacre bleu! Is this the end of Pink Pajama Pierre?
I guess it's true. Black really is slimming. So far, so good. This looks promising. So far, so good. This looks promising.
Dark Ninja Dave with Killer Katana Cutlass waits stealthily for famed out-of-shape pirate hunter Joaquin D'Oro to find him.
Again.
Stop doing that!
Great news, D'Oro. I think your map isn't a ripoff after all.
It isn't? But I never found anything with it.
You must have been reading it wrong. Here, follow me.
And X marks the spot.
See? I told you I could find it.
Whew. I better start digging. I hope it's not as deep as the other ones. Madre de Dios! Dark Ninja Dave! With Chile Karate Katana! Dark Ninja Dave! Dark Ninja Dave! Finally! The full set of porcelain power pirates is mine! All mine!
Ow! I got dirt in my eye. My ears deceive me, or did that portly pirate just dig up a buried treasure?
He sure did, with a little help from Guybrush Threepwood, Mighty Pirate.
Well, that's fantastic. We haven't had a good buried treasure story in weeks. You know, Threepwood, you've got spunk. Pirate spunk.
Ew.
Now, why don't you take a walk with me back to the keel hauler? Tell me a little bit more about yourself.
Well, it all started back on Melee Island. And that's how I wound up here on Flotsam Island.
Well, I don't know how you did it, Seapwood, but thanks to you, I've got enough sordid swashbuckling stories to keep a Flotsam Keel Hauler Gazette afloat for months. That'll show those bozos over at the Times.
Yeah, that's, great. Now, about Deep Gun.
My pleasure, Threepwood. Sit tight while I make you a copy.
Copy?
Tammy, give me a copy of the Deep Gun file, pronto. Right away, Mr. Nipperkin. Here you go, kid. Everything you need to know to contact Deep Gun. Don't let anyone know I gave this to you, okay? My editor will put me on deep cover in the obituary beat. Catch my drift?
Not really, but...
Great! Now, if you'll excuse me, Ace reporter Davey Nipperkin's got some headlines to grab.
Finally! Now I can ask this Deep Gun person how to get off this island and back to Elaine. Seems simple enough.
What's the word?
Deadline.
Welcome, Guybrush.
The Voodoo Lady! Boy, am I glad to see you! I've got so many questions.
There'll be time enough for questions later. But first, hand me the LeChuck Slayer.
The what?
The cursed cutlass of Kaflu. Now that LeChuck has been destroyed, the cutlass must be ritually dismantled in a soul-chilling voodoo ceremony to ensure that his evil never reawakens.
Yeah, about that. I tried to destroy LeChuck with the cutlass, but I had to make some last-second substitutions, and there were some complications.
What manner of complications?
Well, the cutlass didn't so much annihilate LeChuck as it turned him human.
What?
I couldn't believe it either. Personally, I think it's a trick.
A human LeChuck. This is troubling.
Can you help me?
I'll do as much as the fates allow, but I fear that you will not like what I have to say.
Can you help me get off Flotsam Island? I've got a ship, but it won't do me any good with these crazy winds.
The cards say no.
No? Can't you just wiggle your fingers and voodoo schmoodoo the winds to blow out?
What you ask is beyond my power, Guybrush.
Then what in the name of Satan's comb-over are you good for, you bloated old sea hag?
What was that?
That was the pox of LeChuck.
Who the what now?
The pox of LeChuck. When your improperly enchanted cutlass turned LeChuck into a human, all the evil voodoo juju within him had to go somewhere. Were you touching him at the time?
I was. Does that explain the antisocial behavior and the crude gestures?
Yes, some of LeChuck's evil has seeped into your hand.
Do you have a cure?
No, but I know where you can find one.
I feel a piratey quest coming on.
To eliminate the pox of LeChuck, you must seek out La Esponja Grande.
The big sponge?
La Esponja Grande is no ordinary sponge, Treepwood. It is a legendary sea sponge with incredible voodoo exfoliating abilities, capable of absorbing limitless quantities of voodoo mojo.
Where can I find it?
I have never seen it myself, but a former friend of mine, Coronado de Cava, spent many years searching for it. I last saw him in the Jerkbait Islands. Take this locket to him, and tell him I vouch for your character.
I'll get right on it after I find Elaine.
That would be unwise, Guybrush. The pox of LeChuck must be eliminated before it spreads.
Whatever. Can you tell me if Elaine is okay?
The view is hazy. Ask again later.
Later? But she could be in danger, or dead, or worse.
I only know what the spirits reveal, Guybrush Treepwood.
You know, you've been helping me out for years, and I still don't know your name.
Names have power, Guybrush Treepwood. Only a fool willingly gives it away.
Does my name have power?
Sure, why not?
Well, how'd you end up on Flotsam Island?
I go where I am needed.
So you're Deep Gut? Davy Nipperkin's source of off-island news?
Yes.
Why?
The price of a voodoo lifestyle is not merely spiritual, little pirate. It also requires a substantial financial commitment.
Are you sure you can't help me get off Flotsam Island?
As I said, the mysteries of Flotsam are above my pay grade. Seek out others to assist you.
If you can't tell me about Elaine, can you at least tell me where LeChuck is?
Without a mark of the voodoo on him, LeChuck's whereabouts are a mystery to me.
Do you have anything to stave off the pox of LeChuck? His hand is really starting to annoy me.
The only way to safely deal with the pox is La Esponja Grande.
What else can you tell me about the pox of LeChuck?
It's a creeping cloud of unstoppable evil, spreading LeChuck's accumulated vileness like a disease across the seas.
Ugh.
Even now, I can sense the pox wending its way to this very island.
Anything else you think I should know about this pox?
Only that it must be stopped, and that you are the only one who can stop it.
What else can you tell me about the pox of LeChuck?
It's a creeping cloud of unstoppable evil, spreading LeChuck's accumulated vileness like a disease across the seas.
Ugh.
Even now, I can sense the pox wending its way to this very island.
Assuming that I do go looking for La Esponja Grande after I get off this island, what else can you tell me about it?
It's a giant magical sea sponge capable of absorbing immense voodoo energies. If there's anything that can mop up all of LeChuck's evil mojo, it's the sponge.
Tell me more about this locket.
It was given to me by my friend, Coronado de Cava.
Why do you keep putting dramatic pauses around friend? Was Coronado...
Yes, he was my boyfriend.
Icky.
We met in the Jerkbait Islands many years ago. I fell in love with his treasure-hunting mind and his beautiful eyes. He fell in love with my voodoo charms and my supple...
La 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 la, not listening!
Like a volcano! But after several months of ocean steaming passion, our love cooled after he became obsessed with the myth of La Esponja Grande. When we parted, he gave me that locket.
Sad and disquietingly graphic. Well, this has been disturbing, but I've got an island to escape, a wife to find, and apparently a giant voodoo-sucking sponge to hunt.
May the fates guide you, Guybrush Threepwood.
Knock, knock.
Guybrush, don't.
Who's there?
No.
It's me, Guybrush Threepwood, Mighty Pirate.
It's me, Guybrush Threepwood, Mighty Pirate.
You fool.
What?
I've spent months crafting a pyrite parrot of Petaluma, and you've ruined it before it was finished. Now I'll have to start all over.
Sorry. Hey, if you're done with this, can I have it?
Fine. It's of no use to me now.
Who's the studliest pirate in the whole wide world?
Barak! It's me, Guybrush Threepwood, Whitey Pirate.
Heh. What's this?
Ah, the spirits have guided you well. That is a bottle containing an ancient scroll left behind by the Vakalians, the former inhabitants of Flotsam Island.
Ancient scroll, huh? Do you think you can tell me anything about these messed up winds?
Perhaps, but first, you'll have to figure out how to break the unbreakable bottle I've sealed it in.
Unbreakable bottle? Why would you do that?
Some secrets are too dangerous to fall into mortal hands, Threepwood.
Anything else you want to tell me about this scroll in the bottle?
I purchased the scroll from a bitter old pirate named Magee. Make of that what you will.
I guess this thing fell off the roof when I had my little LeChuck episode. I should get shouty more often.
Looks like the wind gods of Flotsam are pointing that way.
Hey there, Threepwood! Do you mind if I get your pirate on the street opinion about the Death Cloud?
Death Cloud? Pox of LeChuck!
The Pox of LeChuck? Pox of LeChuck. Nah, two on the nose, not a pizzazz! Death Cloud is punchy. More in your face, more, ooh, I'm gonna die! Well, I got sick pirates to interview. See ya! Free vowels! Get him while they're vowels!
Ahoy there, scruffy artisan! I'm Guybrush Threepwood, mighty pirate.
Ahoy yourself! I be Gaffer Crimpdigit, pirate glassblower.
What can you tell me about Flotsam Island?
Well, you probably already know about Flotsam Infernal Winds. But has anyone told you about the reefs?
The reefs?
Aye, the crystal reef of Flotsam Island. Sharper than a dragon's tooth, they be. They encircle the island, shredding in a ship foolish enough to get caught in Flotsam's winds.
Yikes. How'd a crusty pirate like yourself wind up making little glass unicorns?
Listen, matey. Glass blowing's every bit as dangerous as sailing the Spanish Main. One false move with your glass jack near the glory hole, and you can kiss your eyebrows goodbye.
I can? I'm not sure that's biologically possible. So, unicorns, huh?
Aye, graceful, delicate creatures they are. Though, to be honest, they aren't selling so well to the pirate community at large. For my next project, maybe I'll be making something that really speaks to them. Assuming I can ever sell these blasted horny buggers.
What's this alphabet sale all about?
Well, it's the latest thing. I make unbreakable tubes in the shapes of letters, which can be used to create festive, illuminated business signs, novelty mementos, or lamps.
Kitschy.
Aye. Very cap. Consonants cost 48 pieces of 8. But today I'm giving away one free vowel per customer. Would you like a vowel?
I think I'd like one of those free vowel tubes.
You'd like to buy a vowel, eh? Here you go.
A U? What about A, E, I, O, or even Y?
All sold out. All we got is U-tubes these days.
What can you tell me about this bottle?
Arr, that'd be one of me special unbreakable bottles.
Unbreakable? Ha! There isn't a bottle alive that's a match for my gift for destruction. Impressive.
The secret ingredients are those jagged crystal reefs. They're tougher than diamonds.
Weird. But what do you do if you want to open one of these unbreakable bottles in order to, say, look at an ancient scroll you've cleverly sealed inside?
Arr, that's a good question, lad. Here, show you how it's done. I use this little beauty to chip off flakes from the reefs and to crack open bottles like this one.
Whoa! So let me get this straight. Your unbreakable bottles are, in fact, opened by breaking them?
Don't get cute, Blandy. I break other things too, you know.
Welcome aboard, sir.
Ben Winslow? What are you doing here?
If it's all right with you, Captain, I'd like to stay aboard as your first mate.
I don't know. I I really don't...
Jolly good, sir. You won't regret it, mark my words. Now, if you'll excuse me, I believe some of my stitches have popped. I'll meet you here if the winds ever change.
A cheese wheel. Monster. Yeah. Still, maybe I'll find some starving rats who will eat it. Hey, it's one of those spiffy new Hungarian easy-action cannons I've been begging Elaine to let me buy. Whoa, the wind's really doing a number on that cannonball.
Unicorns! Be beautiful unicorns!
It's amazing how many of life's problems are solved by indiscriminate cannon fire. Hey there, I'm Guybrush Threepwood, Mighty Pirate. And you are?
It's Hemlock. Hemlock McGee. You!
Me?
Couldn't leave old Hemlock alone with his grog and his tattered dreams, could you?
What the heck happened to your legs?
You mean, aside from some idiot getting a poor old pirate involved in a deadly bar fight?
yeah.
Four words. The Marquis de Saint.
Did the wind shipwreck you on Flotsam Island, too?
I've been trying to suss out these zany zephyrs since I washed up here. I even found an ancient scroll that promised to lead me to all the answers.
No.
But I couldn't figure it out. I got so frustrated that I kicked one of those statues out in the jungle and stubbed me toe. When I went to that butcher, Desange, he cut me leg off!
Ooh, harsh.
Without two good legs, I couldn't explore anymore. So I limped into Club 41 and started up a long-term relationship with a keg of grog.
The Marquis de Singe cut off your legs?
Aye. Not only once, of course. He cut off the horse leg 7 years ago. After I stubbed me toe while investigating the winds of Flotsam Island.
That seems kind of severe.
Sometimes I think that Ponzi Git has it in for me.
You know, even aside from the legs, you're looking a little green at the gills.
Now that you should mind your own big legs, you lily liver tub sucker!
Whoa. What was that?
What was what?
Why aren't you in Club 41, curled up with your grog?
Because the two diamond cannon cloggers kicked me out!
Why?
The club has a strict no feet, no service clause.
Talk about adding insult to injury. Can I see your ancient scroll?
Pray not, Skippy. Some two-bit witch stole it from me in a poker game a few months ago. Won't do any good without my eye of the manatee, though.
Keen, can I borrow it?
Now, why in the name of Neptune's head nails would I let you borrow this priceless artifact of a long-dead civilization?
I was thinking I could carry on your work to make amends for the whole getting your leg hacked off thing.
can't use it anymore, anyhow.
Thanks, Hemlock. I promise you probably won't regret this. I know what would cheer up these gruesome carvings. Cheese! Nope. Still menacing. Oh, and now my cheese wheel is staring at me.
Free vowels! Get 'em while they're vowels!
Looks like I'm gonna have to get my hand under control if I want to break this bottle. I'm not sure whether this is late Rococo or early creepy. Flowers. What a crummy sconce. Now, I better pick this up before someone notices, trips over it. Now, I don't think a flower sconce would enhance the feng shui right here.
Bonjour!
Hi there. Are you a doctor?
Mais oui! I am the Marquis de Singe, former court physician to King Louis himself.
And who might you be?
Guybrush Threepwood, mighty pirate.
Zut alors! Your aunt.
Yeah, I seem to have come down with something.
This is fantastic! We must investigate at once! Très intéressant alors. And you say your sick little hand has a mind of its own?
Yeah, it keeps hitting people, making rude gestures, doing all sorts of stuff I'd never do. Well, not without a really good reason, anyway.
Fascinating.
So, can you fix it?
Monsieur Threepwood, you have my word as a former physician of the court of King Louis that by the time you leave here, your misanthropic hand will never trouble you again.
So, how did a dazzling urbanite like yourself wind up in a sleepy pirate island like Flotsam?
Ah, mon ami, that is a tale of triumph and tragedy. Many years ago, I was a young physician in the court of King Louis. Those were heady days, tending to the many ills of the aristocracy, navigating scandalous palace intrigues. I was a rising star in the scientific firmament.
And then? I mean, then?
A conspiracy of jealous scientists accused me of performing inhuman crossbreeding experiments with the Queen's poodles!
Scientists can be so catty.
The king was outraged and ordered me exiled on this deserted tropical island.
Deserted? Then you were the first?
Oui. Happily, my solitude was short-lived, as the merry winds of Flotsam have conspired to bring me many new pirate patients over the years.
Scientifically speaking, what do you think is the cause of these crazy winds swirling around Flotsam?
Ah, yes, the winds. Personally, I'm convinced that they are a rare but perfectly natural meteorological phenomenon caused by a Lagrange inversion of the atmospheric humors in the upper troposphere, causing a countercyclonic...
Forget I asked.
Incroyable!
So, Doc, what's the verdict?
Ah, monsieur, you are a very lucky man.
I am?
Ah, oui. The disease spreading through your saucy little parrot hand is like nothing I've ever seen before.
That doesn't sound very lucky.
In fact, somewhere in that easing appendage may lie the secret to life itself.
It may? Hey, nice going, Han.
I'll know more after I cut it off.
What? Hey!
But of course, Monsieur Threepwood, the only cure for a hand that infected is a quick, clean amputation.
Amputation? Isn't that a little rash?
No, it's a very big rash, which is why we'll have to amputate. But not to worry, monsieur. Your hand won't feel a thing thanks to my specially concocted grog anesthetic.
Ow!
Now, if you'll just relax here a few minutes, I'll be in the back sharpening my petit guillotine blade. We don't want to cut off our hand with a dull blade now, do we?
Well, I guess you have a point there.
Au revoir.
What a loon. But at least my hand seems under control for a while. I better figure out a way out of this tastefully appointed abattoir before the Marquis de Crazy Pants comes back. Feats don't fail me now. Score one for the pirate with the pointy feet. I hope this works, or I'm about to throw away a perfectly good key.
Jock! Bad monkey! After I take care of Monsieur Sweepwood, it's back in the box for you!
Listen, monkey, if you and I work together, we can both bust out of this joint. What do you say? Are you with me? That's the universal symbol for yes. This looks like it might do something interesting. Ouch! That looked unpleasant. Let's see what this does. Bananas from heaven! Thanks, Banana God! Feet, make yourselves useful. All right, a gross picture of my grosser hand. Things are looking up. I don't think I want to drop this there. I can't reach it from this position. Whoops! I meant to do that. Wait a sec. Is he enjoying this? It's a stack of pictures for that picture in beginning device over there. The key to Singe used to lock me down. If only it weren't so far away.
Ah, 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 ah.
an electromagnetic monkey. I had a dream like that once. Only it was an iguana, not a monkey. And instead of a key, it was an ice cream cone. Plus, I was in my underwear for some reason. Wow, he seems excited about something. It's a cute little bell that makes the monkey play with that picture machine over there. That's it. Come on, you magnificent magnetic monkey. Gotcha! Now, to work the key into the lock. Ta-da!
Monsieur Threepwood, what do you think you're doing? Get back on the table at once.
Sorry, Doc, but I think I should get a second opinion. Thanks for numbing up my hand, though. All that flailing and slapping was getting on my nerves.
Wait! Wait! Stop! I must have your beautiful testifying hand! Come back! Slovenly parrots! Leaving their trash floating all over the place! A parrot hunter, eh?
Elaine, here I come! Or, maybe not. This looks promising.
So far, so good. Thank you. Interesting. Curious. I see.
Whoa. Uh-oh. Someone's coming.
I never thought I'd have to come out here again. But it'll be worth a temporary fluctuation in Flotsam's wind to get my hands on Sweepwood's hand. Anthony's hand. Outroll.
What was that all about? And what's behind that door? Looks like I cut off the door's nose to spite its face. Sometimes it's all I can do to save a little face. I just had a really weird idea.
It's me, Guybrush Threepwood, Whitey Pirate.
I've got a mission for you, little parrot. Go to the other side of this door and open it from the other side. Okay, little champion, open the door.
Stupid bird.
And yet there's still something downright charming about it.
Unicorns! Get your hand-blown glass unicorns!
Doc?
Oh, it's you. Unless you're here to volunteer your hand to the advancement of science, I have nothing to say to you. For now.
Why are you so interested in my hand anyway?
Because the disease that courses through it appears to be an entirely new life form, capable of animating and taking over dead tissues!
No kidding! That's so... Wait, did you say dead tissues? My hand's not dead. It moves. Sometimes all by itself.
And that's what makes it so fascinating. A seemingly necrotic hand, persistently animating as though compelled by an outside force. Just imagine the possibilities.
Really weird puppet shows? You know, there's other sick pirates infected with the same disease as my hand. Why don't you cut off their limbs?
Oh, I have. But your case is special somehow. I must have that hand!
How about no?
We'll just see about that.
What are you doing out here? Don't you have some mildly injured pirates to mangle?
I'm investigating these wondrously icky green clouds that have settled over Flotsam Island.
Are you sure you don't know anything about Flotsam's winds?
What are you insinuating?
It occurs to me that the weird winds around here have been pretty good to you, giving you a steady supply of patience and all.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Come on, confess. You're the guy behind all these freaky winds, aren't you?
What an outrageous accusation! Do you have any proof? I thought not. Good day, sir. I said good day.
Dr. Desinge?
That's the Marquis Desinge to you, ruffian.
Does this look familiar?
Where'd you find that?
It fell off that creepy ancient door in the jungle.
An ancient door with a manatee head in the jungle? I have no idea what you're talking about.
Sure, but you might want to check it out someday. Looks like it could be pretty interesting, scientifically speaking. I'm heading back there now to break through the door with my piratey wiles. First, I'll need some dynamite. Then a rubber chicken with a pulley in the middle, and then some sort of rudimentary lathe.
He'll never open that door without my key. Still, I'd better follow him from a safe distance just to make sure he doesn't upset my long-term plans.
Uh-oh.
Ah, so it appears that Monsieur Threepwood has found the Vecalian Port-du-Vent. Naughty little parrot boy. Is anybody in there?
Arrgh, it's me, Guybrush Threepwood, Mighty Pirate.
What? How did he...
I can't believe he fell for that. This looks like it might be useful. Who's the cleverest pirate in the whole wide world?
Arrgh, it's me, Guybrush Threepwood, Mighty Pirate.
Holy ships!
Threepwood! Well played, Monsieur Threepwood. You have forced me to reveal the location of the hidden temple. But without my help, a simpleton like you will never be able to figure out which of the so-called wind gods must be summoned to master this ancient wind control device. And I will reveal nothing!
That's a wind control device? Thanks for telling me.
You didn't know? I can see it's time for this Marquis to take matters into his own hands.
It's locked. Are still blowing in. Looks like I've got some ancient wind gods to summon. I wonder if that idol can be used to summon wind gods. I see. Faces on those idols look familiar. Oh. That oyster shell looks so empty without a pearl. Cheese wheel with blood and milk curdling impressions of ancient eyeball carvings. like the wind gods of Flotsam are pointing that way. Wind gods on the idols are related to the ones on the weather vane. Must have been the god of winds to knock off your hat.
Sweetwood,
cease your ham-fisted fumblings and surrender that hand.
Make me. Still alive. I know you're supposed to stop and smell the flowers, but this pot looks like someone's taken it a wee bit too literally. Ah, ugh. This one looks like it's missing a nose. Much better. Well, better anyway. Interesting. Wind god that was supposed to... Ew. Broken wind. Got it.
Sweetwood!
Step away from that delicate machinery and give me your hand!
And if I don't? What a grouch. This idol looks like it's missing something. I didn't think it was possible, but this idol's cheesier than ever. Interesting. I wonder if the wind gods on the idols are related to the ones on the weather vane. I see. Weird. Faces on those idols look familiar. That oyster shell looks so empty without a pearl.
Cheetah Alonso. I knew I should have worn my chinos today.
Ah, that must be the wind that makes you reconsider wearing shorts. No sign of the marquee. Good. All that shooting was giving me a headache. Okay, let's figure out the final wind idol thingy and get the heck...
Threepwood!
Oh, jeez. How'd you beat me here, anyway?
Once I heard the search engine's winds, it was child's play for a scientifically trained intellect of my stature to deduce which of the four winds remained.
So, now what?
Now, my annoying pirate friend... You hand over that ancient leverometer device. I restore the winds to their full sucking force, and you accompany me to my laboratorium so that I can properly remove and study your hand with the pointy sticks of science!
Leverometer?
The thing with the seahorse on it!
Oh, yeah, I don't think I'll be giving you that. It's a good thing Desinja's rifle is just as wimpy as the man who built it. You're still here?
But of course.
Hey, look! It's King Louis the 12th!
My liege! I thought you were dead! What was that fooping sound?
Beats me. Now, if you'll just stop waving that rifle around, I've got some winds to change.
Not so fast, insignificant pirate person. Sacre merde!
All right! Ooh, the pox is blowing out to sea. Hope that doesn't come back to bite me in the fundament. Well, I'm sure it'll be fine.
Zut alors! The winds! Do you have any idea what you've done? Without the winds of flotsam bringing me a steady supply of injury-prone paratest subjects, the pace of my groundbreaking experiments was slow to a crawl!
Talk to the hand, sicko, because the pirate ain't listening.
Ugh! Mark my words, Threepwood. You'll rue the day you cross the Marquis de Singe. And your little hand, too.
Rue? I don't know the meaning of the word. Well, looks like my work here is done. I better hurry back to the screaming narwhal before the flotsamites get wind of the, wind. Ben Winslow, where are you?
Right here, sir.
Raise anchor and get us the heck out of here before the winds change.
With pleasure, Captain. Congratulations, sir. The screaming narwhal has successfully escaped from Flotsam Island. Where to now?
Mr. Van Winslow, if you would be so kind, I would like you to set sail for...
Come again, sir.
I said set a course for... Oh, come on!
Come on what, sir? Captain on deck!
That's just swell. My brand new ship's all covered with tar. This is all your fault, you know.
Ow!
Winslow?
Captain?
Just go where I point. Oh, come on!
Ugh, stupid boxed hand!
Joe! What's it?
Can't reach tar sticking pronouns failing!
Guess I'm stuck. Mr. Winslow, make way for the Rock of Gelato.
Aye, aye, Captain.
And get me some grog for this hand. Finally, the Rock of Gelato. Now to find Elaine. Mr. Van Winslow, my spyglass.
Aye, aye, sir.
Elaine's ship looks pretty good, considering that it was exploding the last time I saw it. But where's my ship? And Elaine? Is she out looking for me? Is she still in LeChuck's clutches? Is her beautiful, bloated corpse slowly rotting at the bottom of the... Hey! What's that? Winslow, enhance the upper right quadrant 50%. It's my ship! Winslow, full enhancement! Elaine! I'm coming, Plunder Bunny! Wait, what's that? Oh no, it's LeChuck! Elaine, look out! Plunder Bunny?
Guybrush Threepwood. I've been waiting a long time for this.
Could you wait a little longer?